Hey, this is round one and we are on the draw. We're gonna keep this end even though it's not spectacular. We have our single zone of basic island. And he's gonna resolve a ponder with an island, so this can mean that he's playing Omnitel, which is very reasonable for him. And he did not shuffle the deck. Here I hope to draw an a black source to cast my combo probe into Cabal Therapy. So no, it's not is miracle. So it's counterbalance, snap, pierce, swords, planes, flooded. Okay. And we did not draw any black or red source, so I guess we have to force of will the counterbalance if that comes into play, because we can afford to. Oh, there's a Sunset Divine in top, so here I want to cast a brainstorm. No, he has a spell pierce, so yeah, I'm gonna let this resolve and then cast a brainstorm end of turn. I cannot force of will that, and yeah, I would like to play I could have brainstorm in my turn. Oh, it's very unfortunate for me. So what do I don't want to draw probably is probably Snapcaster that I don't want to draw, because now I'm gonna cast Ponder, hope to fire land or shuffle the deck. He can very reasonable pierce this. No, he doesn't. So I find Volcanic Island, which is actually, I guess it's okay, because then we can Pyroblast. No, it's very difficult because we cannot Pyroblast. Oh no, well, we actually Pyroblast the counterbalance because it just has a planes. So he cannot pierce back with the planes, or we can pyroblast the pierce when we are gonna play the force of will. So actually we have a double counter. We can have triple counter because we have two force of will and two black blue cards, but I'm not really interested in pitching both Dictor Time and Brother. He's gonna look at the top three. And yeah, so now he has counterbalance, Snapcaster, pierce, swords, and the planes in his end. Drew Volcanic Island, so now he's able to cast Pyroblast, counterbalance. We're gonna Pyroblast this, he's gonna pierce, and we are gonna cast Force of Will, probably. Since our top two cards are very bad, I might want to pitch the other Force of Will. His end is not very good. I don't wanna pitch Dig Through Time. I can also cast draw the Snapcaster and cast a Snapcaster Probe and keep the Force of Will in my hand. Yeah, probably is fine. I do this, so that now I draw Snapcaster Probe, and then I have the pitch for Force of Will. This is something like Silver Gill Adept. I recall doing this in the past standard. So his end right now is planes, Snapcaster, swords. Ah, we knew that, so it's fine. And then we pass the turn. Snapcaster Swords Plains. So we drew Caracas and cast a Snapcaster Ponder. That's fine. I will not counter that. And I just f6 here. He has three cards. I can go into combat here so that if I get to draw a black source, I can discard the Swords to Plowshares even if he doesn't have nothing. I mean, if he has like two lands and the swords. Or I just Snapcaster Probe again. He has Pierce, Swords, and Land. Okay, so we got to do that. Actually, discard him the swords. Or maybe I can discard the Pierce so that I can play Dig Through Time this turn. That's kinda close because I might also want to play Snapcaster Probe this turn. That's a very close choice. I think that discarding now Swords to Plowshare will get me a better shape during the game because it's very annoying to type this. Swords to Plowshares. There it is. What's gonna happen? Okay, I name Swords to Plowshare. So he has just a plains and a Pierce. Now I will Snapcaster Probe. I don't really care about the life. And if I want, I can always discard the Spell Pierce to the Cabal Therapy flashback, discarding this, sacrificing the Snapcaster Mage. So spin the top, so it's Plains and Pierce. And then pass the turn. Baleful Streaks is a fine draw. We can keep cycling cards and adding pressure to the board with our Force of Will held in hand, sorry. Another bolt. Now I can start even bolting my opponent. I don't care of getting Spell Pierced. The bolt is at 17, so Cavern of Souls. Name Wizard. If he's playing the version of Jolo set with many creature, I might not want to bolt end of turn. I just take my turn and attack him with two creature. And now I will flash back the Cabal Therapy. Because I only had six cards in my graveyard, so with Dig Through Time I had to exile my whole graveyard, and if I do that, I will lose the bonus. But actually, sacrificing a creature will get me again and on six cards. He now has Force of Will, So I can't cast Dig Through Time without taking Obi. Yeah, probably I can do that in his upkeep. Yeah, I'll do that in his upkeep, so that he will lose his entire turn to Hardcast Force of Will. And I probably force back with True Name Nemesis. Since I already played my two Snapcaster Mage, the graveyard doesn't have any sense anymore. Okay, so he let this resolve. I get a Young Pyromancer and a Force of Will. Or Preordain. Yeah, probably Preordain seems better. Yeah, I already have a Force of Will. Don't have another blue cards to pitch, so that is fine. Idrid Terminus, which I'm very okay with. I'm glad I flashback the turn before the Baleful Strix. And it's gonna pass the turn. I don't wanna bolt because I still have the Young Pyromancer. I drew another Dig Through Time, which is always a good draw. So now play Pyromancer, I will fight over this if he's gonna counter that. He's not, probably. I mean, he can have another Terminus on top. That would be fine. Counterspell, it's an okay card to have. I'll put that in my hand because it's an extra protection. So he just has the Force of Will in his hand. I will remember that without writing. Upkeep, I don't need a stop anymore. There's no miracle, and he's gonna play a counterbalance. I basically need to force that. I will pitch True Name Nemesis. Yeah, True Nemesis is not that great against Miracle. He has 4 Terminus to deal with that. If he's gonna switch the top, cast Force of Will, then I can. I cannot play Bolt. Yeah, he's gonna do that. That is gonna fall on Venser Shaper Servant. I can bolt in his draw phase once the top is no more on the top of his deck. Oh, or I can basically counter the. Yeah, keep drawing bolts. Cannot cast Dig Through Time, but I'm not very interested in doing that. Stop here. And yeah. Cast Lightning Bolt on him. Or probably. Yeah, I will do this just to make sure that on top of his deck there is no to drop. Let's see what's on top of his deck. And there is. He chose not to reveal. Yeah, that's what happened. He chose not to reveal the top card of his deck. Counterspell this. I don't understand why he's not revealing the top, or probably he's doing, but I don't understand where it is. No, because it should be here. So we managed to win this game. Was a good game. Probably I could even let Counterbalance resolve and hold the Force of Will in my hand. That could be a reasonable choice for me. So how to sideboard against the Miracle? Clearly, I want all the cards to deal with Sensei's Divinity on top. Then I want all the Pyroblasts to deal with Counterbalance. And I want also blue elemental blast to deal with his red elemental blast. This is very controversial, but it's actually a thing that happened. It happened to me too. And I don't want anything else here. What I don't want murderous cat, and I don't want all the bolts. Red. 61. We can cut another card, which should be True Name Nemesis. As I said, isn't very good. At least Baleful Strix is a cantrip itself, and is helpful with Cabal Therapy, as you saw that game. So we are ready to play game two. We are back for game two, and yeah, this end is not great, but I'm not gonna complain. Another brainstorm is the draw. I will just play this and pass the turn. I don't need a draw stop anymore. I do not play brainstorm here. I'm just gonna hard cast. Probably with the Polluted Delta. Because since I have Dictor Time in my hand, I wanna as much as fetch land as possible. And this Volcanic Island will be shuffled in my deck with one of these brainstorms. So playing Volcanic Island here is basically that I will put back in the deck a Polluted Delta. This means that I will have one less card in my deck. I could also play the death on turn one and now double fetch. That could be another reasonable choice. Because having three means that probably one is gonna be shuffled in the deck. Yeah. I didn't thought about that. Here he cast a brainstorm, so he could have a terminus on top, but I don't really care. I mean, this Baleful Strix did his job if he's gonna take a terminus. Gonna wrap this, it's gonna red elemental blast this. Okay, that's fine. Okay, I will start the turn by brainstorming with this red land, because since I can hit Cabal Therapy, I wanna cast it. Oh yeah, sure. Yeah, I should have cast my land first. I totally forgot about Pierce, but I mean that wasn't even that bad. Okay, so he fought over all my brainstorms, which kinda sucks because my hand is not very good if my dig doesn't resolve. Okay. Then I'll cast Polluted Delta. Yeah, this was all about casting this Polluted Delta as a first card in the turn. Yeah, completely forgot about Spell Pierce. But usually you don't cast Polluted Delta because he might think, oh, he doesn't have lands, I want to counter this, play Pyroblast. Which is a hard counter, and you're okay with trading Pyroblast or Counterspell or whatever with the Brainstorm. But yeah, at this point, Spell Pierce, you could easily play around Spell Pierce at this stage of the game for the rest of the game. But that wasn't my case, since I didn't. So yeah, he's gonna cast his beautiful Brainstorm Commandeer, which I very like. And just pass the turn again. So yeah, not many action from my opponent. I don't wanna fetch here, since I can draw another Brainstorm. Yeah, that is. I will cast this once again. And everything resolve, I will put back these two cards. So here I want to cast Preordain first. No, I want to cast Cabal Therapy, because I'm not gonna search with Preordain something to like a Cabal Therapy, what's the name, Jadaxian Probe, because if I see that there's anything in his hand, I can resolve a Dictor Time. So here I can choose a lot of things. Tia can verb Snapcaster Mage. I love this card. I don't think it's a Lightning Force of Will. Dig through time there. This is a very bad end for me. Jace, dig, it's it. I can't really cast dig through time because then he can cast his own one and find something like Pyroblast or Red Elemental Blast. But I can cast Preordain. No, because then he can, in response to my fetch land, cast dig through time. So yeah, I'm forced to pass the turn now, but he fetch, and I'm okay with. Fetch it again, and I am okay with again. So here, if he's gonna play dig through time, I have to play my own. But that, let's see what I want. Okay, so there is Pything Needle, which I certainly have to take, and probably Force of Will. Then I will Force of Will this dig through time. He's gonna play Jace, probably plus two, and then I will play Pything Needle. This is fine by me. So taking Pithing Needle and Force of Will. Binning many good cards, also Cabal Therapy. Be great here. So Force of Will this, pitching Preordain. Then just pass the turn. He's gonna play Jace, plus two. Cannot afford to. No, he's gonna straight brainstorm. Yeah, I worried about bolts, but that's not a thing that everyone's do. What else? Sunset's Divine Top. So now I have the choice. Let's see what a ponder gave it to me. Oh, many, many good cards here. I will likely draw a Reb now. Reb the, I don't know the order here. Probably it's gonna be a Reb third. Yeah. So that next turn I can have a dig through time. No. Cast the Red Elemental Blast right now. And the Pithing Needle on the top. Yeah, this turned out very well for me. You can switch now if he has Brainstorm and a fetch land, but just decided not to. And now I once again have six cards in the graveyard. Counterbalance is the draw. This is fine. I think no, I would pass. Since the top card of my deck is very good, I want to draw that before casting Dig Through Time. And now I can cast it, or just, yeah, I can also Pyroblast the counterbalance, but I want to be sure that that the top of his deck is not a one drop. Casting this right now means that I will have to remove the Cabal Therapy. Since I don't wanna do that, I will just pass the turn. I prefer to do something in response. Yes, also it's a Stratocaster in his end. Oh, no, probably, yeah, oops. I drew Counterspell, which is another reactive card. I keep being behind right now. So he drew a Miracle, most likely, because he posed. And now I can do something. I mean, I forget about the... Yeah, Cabal Therapy did his job. No, probably no, he didn't, but... I hope he's gonna reveal something right now. Let's see if he does. He does not again. So he choose not to be lucky. I think Young Pyromancer. And probably... And probably... I don't know about Ponder, Preordain, or Probe. I wanna take one of those. Or maybe Pyroblast. Or maybe just Pyroblast. Yeah, so that now I will Pyroblast end of turn. And... or no. No, I don't. I take my turn. Blue Elemental Blast. A lot of variety. Variety. Let's see if this time you choose to counter something. So he revealed the top card now this time, and it was a Plains. So now I am free to Pyroblast this one. Should have done it in his upkeep though. This was a misplay by me. It was a big misplay by me. Let's see if I got punished for this. Sword Supply Share, I'm not gonna force this. So this is fine. Yeah, I was very punished for this. This is in the Stratocaster. I can Blue Elemental Blast this. Yeah, I should have done this all. Ah, no. He would have cast the Isa Stratocaster in my end of turn. Okay, so everything works fine. He has two cards in hand, probably Miracle among them. And on top of his deck, there's a Plains that he's gonna draw. There it is. And now I get to attack with my Young Elemental. Cabal Therapy. It's not the best. I think I don't want to cast it. I will save it for further. Or I might just name Entry the Angel. This is the most problematic. I don't care about top 6 Terminus. Yeah, if it was Entry the Angel, he would have cast it. So I'm just gonna name Terminus here. There it is. And Sunset Divine in top. I'm not sure about casting the Scalding Tarn, since I have already mana I need. And I will held in case I draw a Brainstorm and another Fetchland, for example. Okay, so we just drew Pluto Delta. Pithing Needle. Yeah, this time I'm gonna play the Scalding Tarn, since I can top 5 Force of Will. This is a very slow clock, but it is at least something. He has basically nothing in his hand. We have 4 good cards. Yeah, he drew another land. I think I will pay one life. Sorry, pay a mana right here, because if he draws any spell, I can counterspell that. Yeah, I drew another Scalding Tarn that I'm gonna fetch. Okay, so he's gonna pass the turn. I'm fetching my upkeep for a basic island in case he has something like Blood Moon. You'll never know. But drew another fetch land. The point with this pithing needle is that I might keep it because if you find something to remove this pithing needle, I will play another one on Sunset's Divine in top. I don't want to play it first on Jace because Jace this is not very good against my hand. If he's gonna play Jace, I would just probably I would just let it resolve. Okay, so he's gonna cast another top. I don't know what this mean. He's probably bored not to play any spell. Just taking hit from this elemental token. I'm very far behind in time also. I didn't notice that. So E as a stop in my upkeep, as an effect in my upkeep, probably. I should have cast that Polluted Delta, probably, because I could have had two counter spell up. I mean, I also always have to counter spell up with Pyroblast. So. And now I'm gonna play the Pyromancer. And this. He's gonna counter these, I'm fine. These enchant on Pithing Needle. So since he has two fetch land, he's gonna get a lot of advantage from this. And since he has only one card in hand, yeah, he's gonna then switch the top. No, I can't afford to let this disenchant resolve. So I will counterspell this. And now I'm gonna play the land because I don't want to be my Pyroblast spell pierced. Stoneforge Mystic. That I can do anything about. That could be very problematic. He took a butter skull. Yeah, that is very problematic. That's very unlikely that I drew Pyromancer just that turn because I need all the Force of Will plus counter spell. So yeah, the butter skull is gonna comes into play. I can't do anything about it. And Snapcaster Maze is a good draw. It's indeed a good draw. And I'm gonna fire it off right now. On a Dig Through Time. Leaving just Cabal Therapy in my graveyard. And I find another Dig Through Time, probably. I'm gonna take it, yes. And a Brainstorm. Yes. Could also take the probe. Then cast this Brainstorm. Null Rod. I don't really need this. And I probably don't need even this Dig Through Time. Yeah, and cast a Ponder. I want to draw these beautiful streaks and then that. And then that null rod, so that his battle school will not longer comes back in his end. I will just chump block this one this turn. Yeah, I probably should have kept that null rod the first time. And yeah. So now I will resolve a null rod. Cast the Strix. And name something in his hand. Naming a random card since I'm running low on time. Flusterstorm since it has Divining top. I'm not interested in doing anything else and I would just pass the turn. I can lose this game only by time, I guess. Should have probably removed that Flusterstorm. I'm now tilting because of the 4 minutes left. And the Snapcaster Mage. Gonna go ahead and counter that spell. Yeah, I should have definitely discard this Flusterstorm. Now I have to force the Snapcaster Mage. And I am out of gas. He just have one Senses Divine top in his hand. I'm gonna hit with one Baleful Strix. Now my plan is to float out of creature, hope he doesn't draw a Terminus right now. Then cast Purrdane. Held the Force of Will in my hand. I misplayed the turn before. I should have cast Cabal Therapy in my graveyard. And create a token because I had two young Pyromancer. Here I probably lose time doing this useless thing, but if he's gonna draw counterspell, that will actually be a card. And I forgot to deal this damage. He for sure doesn't have anything in his deck, so I'm just gonna let this resolve. To Pyroblast in his hand. Come on. Okay, this is a good draw because the clock now gets shorter. just f6 and couldn't counter that. Yeah, but I don't think I would want to do that. So now I have to count. Do I win if I attack with all? He's blocking this three. No, I don't win, right? He's blocking this three, trades, block here, taking nine. Yeah, I cannot do anything. I have also 10 cards in my deck. This is probably more an issue than the time. Spell. You actually can cast that on Pithing Needle, but yeah, I don't want to do that. I could also have countered this Stoneforge Mystic. That okay, so this is basically a double Demonic Tutor. I do not have bolts anymore in my deck, so this is very strange game. Snapcaster Ponder will be my choice here. Cast a Ponder. 2 minutes on the clock, less than 2 minutes. No. Cabal Therapy, my opponent. I'm gonna cast something uncounterable. That is Bendelian Click. I can let this resolve. Then with the trigger on the stack, I will cast Snapcaster Mage on Pyroblast. Then I will play my land since there is all an underground sea in the deck. So it puts me down Force of Will. Now next turn. Yeah. I forgot to flashback the Cabal Therapy. And now next turn, I will be able to attack with everything, and that should be game. Thanks to the new client, Magical Lion, I cannot do this, since this was very helpful. And with 4 cards in the deck and 35 seconds in the timer, I should manage to win this game. So he did this so that I would have waste more time to order the blocker. So yeah, that was a very good game. I hope you enjoyed, and we'll be back for round 2.